So the reason the RR exists is that it's a homologation special. The cylinder head has been adapted so it can take higher lift cams, although it's got standard cams in stock form, and the engine casing is more rigid, so it can handle more power. So really, that's the reason this bike exists, so the World Superbike teams can tune the bejesus out of it. Next year's Superbike rules are more restricted, more towards super stock, so the higher spec the bike is in standard trim, the better it's going to do at Superbike racing, which is, say, why Ducati, for example, with their Panigale R, which has got a race engine in it, standard, is going to do quite well next year. Apart from those engine mods, which really make no difference to power, still got the same 197 horsepower, which is about 192 at the back wheel, still got the same torque, still weighs the same. Now the RR costs about £1,900 more than the standard version, and for that you're going to get diamond like carbon coated tappets, RR engraved engine cover and a logo on the key. It's single seat and only available in winter testing colours. There's no rear footrests. You get Pirelli Diablo Supercourser SP tyres, a quick shifter and an auto blipper, and Marchesini forged aluminium wheels. Now if we were to have ridden this bike in standard trim, it wouldn't feel that different from the standard ZX-10, apart from the slightly faster steering you get from the wheels and the convenience of the auto blipper. So what Kawasaki have done is fitted a few well chosen parts from their race kit to give the ZX-10R a little bit more pep, but obviously you could fit this to the standard bike as well as the RR. So it's got a race kit and ECU. Now the race kit gives slightly racier traction control, gives the bike more mid-range, and it gives it that auto blipper. It's got all the ABS system ripped out of it, and steel lines replace the rubber hoses. It's got a full Akrapovic titanium exhaust system with a carbon can. It's got race kit head angle adjusters, so they've reduced it from 24 degrees to 23.5 degrees. The fork setting is a little bit softer, and the rear shock setting is a little bit harder than the road bike. They've added a 1mm shim to the rear shock to jack the rear up, and they've put Pirelli Diablo Supercourser SC1 race tyres on it as well. Riding around the track, you instantly feel the bike's got a lot more mid-range. It's standard, the bike's quite lazy off of corners, it kind of... then it goes. It's got 197 horsepower. It doesn't actually feel it in standard trim unless you absolutely thrash it, but it does now. It's got a lot more mid-range, the steering is a lot lighter, and that's a combination of the wheels and the head angle adjustments and the suspension adjustments, and you still got that really nice shower plush ride quality, which makes the ZX-10 such a nice bike to ride on the road. The brakes are an improvement, there's more power, there's more feel, but even with its ABS ripped off, you still get that kind of strange spongy feel at the lever, which you don't get with other Brembo equipped bikes. The traction control and anti-wheelie are a little bit different to standard. On the standard bike, you can't really feel it so much, but on this bike, it's a lot more pronounced and it makes a lot nicer noise. It coughs and splutters when the electronics come in, so you really feel like they're doing something. It actually gives you confidence just to push harder. Feels a lot like the Superbike, actually. The ZX-10RR isn't too different from standard, apart from those wheels and auto blipper. It's really a bike for the race teams to allow them to tune the engine. But what our test did show today was that with a few well-chosen mods from the race kit, suspension tweaks, that kind of thing, you can actually make the ZX-10 into a lot more nimble, a lot gruntier machine that would hold its head high against its rivals.